guys, welcome back to my channel. Well, what we're going to do today is I want to make a farmhouse French country, and it would even work Tuscan DIY for your home using paint stir sticks. And I want to make like those old toolboxes that were wooden that they used to carry a long time ago. This is so easy, and I think it's going to be very pretty. So let me show you what you'll need in case you want to make this super easy farmhouse DIY with paint stir sticks. Okay, you're going to need a total of 12 paint stir sticks. I got mine from Home Depot. We've had these laying around the house for quite a while now, where I was doing all those other paint stir stick DIYs. They're the 5-gallon ones. You can either use Lowe's or Home Depot, it doesn't matter. And so you'll need 12 of those. And then you're going to need a plunger from the Dollar Tree, and I just took the end off. And you don't need to cut this down at all, and I'm going to leave this end on it. I think it's going to be really cute. And then you're going to need some Waverly chalk paint in the mineral. I've used this many times. And then the Waverly chalk paint in the plaster. I love it. I think it's going to be really pretty. I did a paint stir stick box and painted it that way, and it was gorgeous. Then you're gonna need a well-loved brush for dry brushing, a foam brush, and maybe just a brush, and a glue gun. I'm going to put mine together with hot glue. I would suggest that you use E6000 in combination with the hot glue. The hot glue will hold it until the E6000 sets, but I have a lot of allergies, so I'm not going to be using that. So and also you're going to need some screws. And I just had some pocket screws that are 1 1/4 just around the house. So that's what we're going to be using. So let me go ahead and get everything ready and we'll start painting and assembling this. Okay, first what I'm going to do is use this mineral chalk paint from Waverly. And I love the color that it gives you. And I'm going to paint both sides of these paint stir sticks with it. Actually, I think I used a different color before. Okay. And just put, you probably only need one good coat, maybe two, to hide where it says Home Depot. Probably two coats, but that's what we're getting so far. You can use a darker one and it won't take as much. So for time purposes, I know you know what I'm doing, so I'm going to go ahead and paint all my paint stir sticks and the plunger handle with this chalk paint, and I'll be back. Okay, I've painted both sides with the mineral chalk paint. I think it looks really good. And now I'm going to dry brush. I really don't know what color. I think I'm gonna start off with the Waverly chalk paint in plaster. And I just have, I have a little bit of dark on my this brush, so I think I'm just going to put a little bit on this one and kind of like, dab it off and see what I think about this. I think I'm liking this pretty well. Just kind of put it on there, drag it. Kind of like that. I think that's cute. I think I got a little bit too much right there, so I'll just put a little bit more over here and it'll work. All right. And so that's what I'm going to be doing. If I change my colors or add any other colors, I'll come back on and let you see. But for now, I'm really liking this effect. So that's what I'm going to do. And when I get this all dry brushed, I'll be back. Okay, I've got everything dry brushed, as you can see, with that Waverly chalk paint in plaster. I really think it gives it a nice old feel. You could paint these any color that you wanted, but I really wanted one like this. Now you're going to take what I call your braces, and you need three of these. You're going to need seven in total, and I'll put all this in the description box in case you're interested. But for the bottom, you're going to need three of these, and they are cut 4 1/4, okay, all three of them. So what we're going to do is then you're going to take for the very bottom three of these paint stir sticks that are 16 7/8, okay? And what we're going to do is we're just going to get a square here and line them up right here because it's really important that they are straight. And we're just going to put some hot glue right on here. Like I said, I would suggest that you use E6000 and the hot glue, but I'm not going to. And this is really just to give it support. And you're not going to see this, so it's really not going to matter. And right now we're building this upside down for right now. Okay, and then we're just going to glue this right here and make sure everything is flush, because like I said, it's going to throw it off later if it isn't. Okay, now this is what we have. This is what the inside of our bottom is, and this is the underside, which is cute with itself. You want to take your two long sides that are 17 3/8 inch and put them on here so that you'll have room to butt this up and it'll still fit, okay? So I'm going to take and put some glue right along here. And snug this right in there like that. Okay, then I'm going to do the same thing down here on this side, but keep these ends, I hope you can see, so that they'll still fit. I'm not a carpenter at all. I'm sure my husband would do this totally different, but to me this is the simplest way to do it, okay? All right, now we have this right here, okay? Now what we're going to do is then see which side we want to have facing. Now, I like that side. And I think I want this inside. So now what we're going to do is just put some glue right down through here, all across the bottom. Like I said, I would use E6000 in combination with hot glue. And then we're just going to take this, put it flush, and that's what we have so far. This would even be a cute window ledge. You could do so much with this. Okay. Same principle here. Going to take our glue right down through here, all across this bottom. Make sure that it's flush and press it together, okay? All right, and that's what we have so far. I think this is adorable. All right, now what you want to do is we're going to take this piece and put it here, but we have to make sure we have enough room for all of our pieces to fit. Okay, now you want to take these, you're going to have four of these, what I call sides of the handles, and they're cut at 9 inches, okay? I'm going to put a little bit of glue on here, and then we're just going to put it in the middle of, on this side of this bottom piece. We're putting, they all have to go from here to here, inside that, okay? Okay, then the handle goes in the middle. I'm gonna snug that right like that. This is really easy. Then this one gets some glue and it's going right like that, okay? Now, to give this some support, what we're going to do is take another one of these and put it up here, okay? And I think I want it to be like this. You could really do however you wanted. And we're going to put this right like this. And this gives this much, it's much more sturdy like this, okay? All right, and then we're just going to repeat the same on this side. So for time purposes, as soon as I get this side done, I'll be back. Okay, and this is what we have so far. I think it is so pretty. You could make this middle as deep as you wanted. I didn't want mine very deep because of what I'm going to be doing with mine. Now you just take this plunger and you just drill a hole in this. Now I had my husband drill the hole, and because we have two of these pocket screws that we just had around the house, they're an inch and a fourth. So he drilled a 1/8 inch hole, okay? All you have to do is just put this up here and it's going to give it even more support. See where I'm going? And I like it because this just looks old and it's a round end. I love that, okay? I'm going to stick this right in here and start screwing this in till I get it. Okay, like that. Here's what it looks like on the end. I just love this. And we're going to do the same principle right here. And I hardly have any money at all in this. Okay, we'll take a look at it. Okay, here it is. I love how it turned out. It just looks so French country farmhouse. It's a lovely little DIY. And like I said, you can make it as high here, as deep as you want it, but I don't want mine that deep. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and show you what this looks like on my table, and I'll style it just a little bit. I'm pretty sure I'm going to put something like this in the center, if not this. So I'll be right back. Okay, here it is. You could style it however you wanted, but I love how that turned out. It just looks so old farmhouse, French country, even like a Tuscan DIY. It is so pretty, but you can see right here, it just gives such a nice look to the dining room. So I'm pretty sure I really like those pots in my kitchen, but I'm thinking I may leave these on here and maybe make something else for my kitchen. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Until next time, bye guys.